test, 1, 2, testing.
Good, I'm good.
Lisa, how you doing?
Good.
Great. Ladies and gentlemen, I just want to say a couple of words real quick. Jack Smith was my best friend in the world. He was like a brother to me. Jack and I had a lot of firsts at this racetrack. This is the first place I met Jack. This is the first place that Jack ever came to a race. And this was the first racetrack we were thrown out of. We did a lot with Karnak.com. Scott McAllister and I are still trying to do it. The love and support that the racing community gave us when Jack was sick and when he passed away was just, it was unbelievable. But I lost a great friend. But I still have a ton of great friends here. I'd like to ask everybody to just please stand up for a second. Let's get everybody just stand up for a second. And put your hands together for the greatest race fans in the state of Florida, Full Throttle Speedway. You are awesome! Are you guys ready for some open wheels?
Yeah!
Oh, come on, let's hear it, Miss Sarasota. Are you ready for some open wheels?
Yeah!
All right, let's give them the Karnak four most famous words in motorsports.
Gentlemen, start your engines!
Fire them up! Let's go open wheel racing! I want to thank Jason Beckner, Kevin, Mike, everybody who invited me out tonight to be part of this race. I want to thank each and one of you for coming out. Don't forget Karnak.com, your home for internet racing. We've got it all there. All our racing shows are still there. Once again, make sure you come out here every Saturday night. Bring a friend with you. Florida Stock Car Racing needs you. I love you guys. Thank you.
Another night of racing in the books. Welcome to Turn 5 Racing, and I've changed the name of it tonight. It is not Turn 5. It is Real Racing USA. So something that we did religiously on a weekly basis with Jack Smith. We just got finished with the Open Wheel Modified James Carter Attorney at Law Jack Smith Memorial Race tonight here at the Full Throttle Speedway. And couldn't finish off this night any better with Alicia. Is it Alisa? Alisa Smith, Jack's daughter, and Kathy, Jack's wife. And it was. I'm going to start with you, Kathy. And we had a good time tonight. That was a lot of fun.
I had a wonderful time. There couldn't have been a better tribute. Jack's smiling, and he's probably taking a lot of pictures.
I was talking to Kevin Williams earlier tonight. He had come up in the tower in the middle of the races. I said, I think we need to have a Jack Smith ponytail night at the races.
That would be a good thing, yeah. Yeah, that would be a good thing. Jack Smith ponytail.
Yep. Everybody that gets in, everybody has a ponytail gets in for free.
That would be great. That's a good tribute.
I'm gonna try to suit that up for the next Jack Smith Memorial Race.
You got it. That's a good thing.
You know, we don't get to see each other too much, and I was talking to you today. I'm gonna slide by because I make that run up and down the road to Full Throttle now, you know, once a week. But how have you been doing?
I'm doing great. I'm keeping busy. You know, that's all I can do. It helps. Stay busy. I miss him like crazy, but you know, it's one of the things this world, it happens, and there's not much you can do about it.
Well, you know, it's like we all miss him, but the best thing we can do, I believe, is like things we did tonight, and remembering him, keeping his spirit alive, and even with Karnak, it's still out there, and everybody's still having a good time with it.
He loved the racing community so much. That was his life for 16 years. And to tell you the truth, Elisa can verify this, that man lived, slept, ate racing. He just loved the racing people. And it's a shame he can't be here, but I hope the people remember him and remember the things that he stood for, because he wanted this racing community to come together, the racetracks be good, and it's finally happened. You know, all the racetracks. This was Jack's first racetrack he ever came to, and he loved it so much that he started Karnak.
Yeah, first track he ever got kicked out of. And were you here for that?
No, I wasn't.
What's been your feeling tonight since taking this all in? I know that everybody had signed the VP Racing Fuels checkered flag tonight. Everybody signed it on there and everything. And I know you had a long haul coming down from Pennsylvania. Did you have fun tonight?
Oh, my God, yeah. It was wonderful. I can't even express. I mean, I'm so proud to be Jack Smith's daughter.
You know, and it's kind of neat. I'm kind of on edge. I'm like, okay, we're going to do this again next year. And it's like, I've got all these ideas and everything we can do to make it bigger and better. And he's probably up there just shaking his head at us going, oh, yeah. Come on, guys.
Yeah, exactly. He was very humble. So, yeah. And this would be overwhelming to him, but it's just amazing how many people actually cared about him. And people either loved him or hated him, but in the end, you just gotta love the man, because if you hated him, it was because he gave you a challenge.
I think what was the funniest, even the people that didn't like him, they just had to kind of sit back and laugh a little bit with him, too. You know, it's like, okay, yeah, he got me on that one. But my favorite memory of Jack was whenever I would come to your guys' house to do Real Racing USA, and I'd walk in and he'd have Eric Clapton or some blues player or Stevie Ray Vaughan, or he'd be playing the St. Pete Boogie or something like that. I mean, just his not only his love of racing, but his love of music too.
Absolutely. He loved music and he played it all the time, and he took a lot of pride in the way he set up his shows and the music that he used. And every time that he used the music, it was for a reason. And he loved it. He just loved it. It was a passion. Jack was very passionate about racing, mostly because of the people. He saw a wonderful community. He saw people come together, get to know each other, help each other. Excuse me. And he loved that, and he loved being in the middle of it. But he never loved being on Front Street.
never did at all.
Mm-hmm. No.
Yeah. I always enjoyed coming up the road and knew I was going to spend the evening with you guys doing the radio show and everything, and it never ceased to amaze me, even when there was something bad going on at the racetrack, how calm and how caring and how generally concerned he was for people and just racing in itself. And you guys had the majority of your life with him, but, you know, and we only had Saturdays or once a week with the radio show. And I know I miss him. I know you guys miss him, but I'm glad that we can still do this for him.
Oh, I do. I'm just overwhelmed. I just think it's absolutely wonderful. I miss my daddy so much.
Well, we'll do this again next year, and then we'll make an even bigger party out of it. How about that?
Yeah, I agree with that.
All right. And it was always nice seeing you, and I'll stop by and see you, okay, Kathy?
You better.
I will. If I don't, I know you're going to kick my butt or get Carol after me or something like that.
You don't want that.
No. And actually, I was looking on Karnak today on the message board. And if you folks get a chance to see it, Carol made this beautiful butterfly garden in her backyard.
She did, and I have seen it. And it's all in tribute to Jack, because Jack loved the butterfly gardens. And she did a beautiful job of it, too. She really did. And It's something that is a great tribute as far as I'm concerned. Carol was a very, very close, good friend. And I don't get to see her that much, but I miss her.
Well, I'll drag her along with me. She's closer to you, too.
Absolutely, she is, yes.
We'll bring some shrimp and strawberries over.
Oh, boy. And her famous cakes.
Oh, my goodness, yeah, we'll have to get her on that. And Kathy, Alicia? Alyssa.
Alyssa.
I got it wrong so many. Oh man, I'm batting 1,000. But that's all right. Ladies, we're going to do this again next year, and I can't wait to have you back.
Thank you so much, Jason. For everything that's done, we thank the track. The track worked very, all the people involved to make this come about, and it was a wonderful tribute.
Thanks, Kathy. And we're going to see you next year too, right?
Oh yeah, most definitely. Hopefully the grandkids will be able to come too, so.
Well, we'll be here. We'll be ready for them. We'll have another checkered flag.
Okay. Yeah, I'm going to have to fight my kids for this one.
Well, another great night of racing at the Full Throttle Speedway. What a great way to finish it off with the Jack Smith Memorial. The Smith ladies here with us, Jack's wife and his daughter. And we're going to do it again next year. And the fireworks tonight. That was unbelievable. That's too cool. And I think tonight on the way home, I'm going to listen to some Eric Clapton. So. Real loud. There we go. We're going to do it up. Another episode of Real Racing USA right here at the Full Throttle Speedway and my Turn 5 bar. We'll see you next Saturday night where all the action is and it's wide open at the Full Throttle Speedway. Thanks, Jack.